In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use a Goodman and Kruskal gamma test to look at your ordinal data. So ordinal data are categorical that follow an order, so it is important the order that they go in. This is a study about student opinions on GAI technology. They had their level of study recorded, for example, were they foundation, undergraduate, taught postgraduate or research postgraduate, and also they reported their self-confidence levels in academic writing. So one was a confidence of not very confident and five was very confident in academic writing. So we want to see if there's a relationship as students progress through university, does that affect their confidence in terms of their academic writing? Now, one thing that I've had to do is for level of study, we had an option in the survey that some students, they didn't perhaps know what their level was. So I did create another variable which allowed me to treat any unknowns as missing data, basically. So if the student didn't know, let's open this box just to show you. So here, if they weren't sure what level they were at, they were given a 5. But if I left this as it was, then this would be considered an increase compared to, say, PGR. So this would be seen as a next level up, and that's not what I want. So it was important that I went into the missing here and I identified that anything with a code of 5 could be treated as a missing variable. So I just wanted to point out that I had to do that for this to work. Okay, so you go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, and then to Crosstabs. In terms of the assumption for this test, the data have to be ordinal, so both variables do have to be ordinal, and it is ideal that they have a monotonic relationship. So in other words, as one increases, the other one also increases, or as one increases, the other one decreases. If there isn't really that relationship, it's potentially not going to be a very useful test anyway. So level of confidence we can put in because there was only the 1 to 5 option, but we are going to have to put this variable in down here where I specified that level 5 or answer of 5 was actually missing data. So we're going to just put these in. Then we go here to statistics and you can see that we have a box here called ordinal. And if we just tick gamma, this should then allow us to run our Goodman and Kruskal's gamma. Press continue and OK. So we are given 3 different tables. The first table tells us how many missing observations we have. So we have 10 missing observations here, but we knew that was probably going to happen because we did have a few students who weren't quite sure what level they were at. You can then see here that we have the foundation level students, of which there were only 17. Undergraduate, we have over 1,700. The taught postgraduates, these tend to be master's level, we have over 500 and we have 579. And then our PGRs, so these are our research postgraduates, so these are usually our PhD students. We don't have quite as many, we have about 167. So we can start to already identify certain trends by looking at the cross tab. So for example, I can see here, if I look at the undergraduates, I have quite a similar number who recorded their confidence levels in writing as a 3. So this would be about average to slightly above average here. So 4. So remember, 5 is most confident and 1 is least confident. So we have quite a similar number who would rate themselves as pretty confident and sort of average confidence here in terms of our undergraduates. When we get to our taught postgraduates, we have slightly more proportionally out of those taught postgraduates who are perhaps scoring themselves a 4 compared to a 3. And when we then go on to our PhDs, we can see that we have over double of them have recorded themselves as a 4 compared to how many recorded themselves as a 3. So we're already starting to get a feel for the data and what we might discover. Down here, the value under gamma, this is our gamma value. So this is telling us the direction and the strength of our relationship. So we know the direction is positive because this is a positive number. It does not have a minus sign in front of it. So as students progress through university, as their level increases, their confidence in academic writing appears to increase. Another way we could phrase this, it might be that the students who have more confidence in academic writing are more likely to stay on and to then do a master's and then to potentially do a PhD as well. We can then look here at our significance level, which shows us that this was not just due to chance. So we can reject the null hypothesis here. The null hypothesis would be to say that there is no relationship between level of study and confidence in academic writing. We can reject that and say it does appear as though there is a relationship. In terms of the strength of the relationship, so that may depend upon the references that you read, it may depend on your subject area. So I have found a reference, which is what I will base this on. So remember, this is 0.253. So there's an article here talking about the different levels and interpretations of gamma. Some of them aren't quite this detailed. They don't quite go into this many categories. So our value is somewhere here. So this would be considered a low association. A few other sources I've read have also called it a moderate. I think anything that says weak, low, moderate would be fair for something which is 0.2. I think once you start getting above 0.5, you are a bit more justified to perhaps say strong, or you could be quite strict and use the criteria that have been mentioned here in a book. So I hope that was useful for you to perform and interpret your Goodman and Kruskal gamma.